Hi, welcome to Fixed by Doc, and today I have a requested video for you about why we chose to go off-grid. I'll try to keep it short. The main reason why we chose to go off-grid is because we basically got tired of paying people to do stuff for us that we can do ourselves. And such as electric. We can provide our own electric if we connect to wind and solar. And we can provide our own water if we connect to a well or a spring, which at our house we connect to a spring. With our waste management, we can care for our own waste management if we switch to a composting toilet, a waterless composting toilet, and process our own human manure. And by going off-grid and taking care of stuff ourselves, we end up saving a lot of money, and we end up not having to worry about paying somebody else to do things for us that we could do it for ourselves. That's pretty much the main reason. It's like, we can handle all this stuff on our own, and we don't have to worry about these things breaking down and waiting for that company to come out and fix it and repair it. We can, when we were on grid, at least once a month, something would break down. Either the septic lines would back up, or the power would go out, or there'd be something wrong with the water, or something. There's always something going on with on-grid utilities that you've always got to worry about. I've been off-grid now for just over 24 months, and we haven't had any issues. The very first summer we went off-grid, we installed our water and electric and composting toilet and all that good stuff, and we haven't had any issues since then. So I can honestly say we've gone 2 years without a single breakdown of anything, and that is like the biggest reason, the main reason why we went off grid, and because we can live a stress-free life knowing that when I flip my light switch, I'm going to have electricity. And I know I'm going to have electricity because I'm creating it myself with my own solar panels and my own wind turbine. And I'm in charge of it. And I know every aspect from the moment I collect that power to the moment it's stored in my battery bank to the moment I use it. I know exactly how much I have and where it's going and what's being done with it, and I don't have to pay somebody else to do it for me, and there's not hundreds of miles of power lines running down the road that I got to worry about freezing and snapping off, or somebody getting in a car accident and taking out a power pole or something like that. It runs 30 feet out my front door to my wind turbine and my solar panels, and all I got to worry about is that 30 feet, and we're good. Same thing with your water lines and all that other kind of stuff. Being off-grid means that you're in charge of your own resources and your own stuff. And there's not all that crap that you got to deal with. And you know, you don't get those bills in the mail every month that you got to worry about, how am I going to pay these and pay those and pay those. And now, when I lived on-grid, it wasn't that we couldn't afford to live on grid, because we can. We make four times the amount of money that we needed to live on grid. We had a nice house that was on a quarter acre lot, and we made more than enough money to afford to live on grid. We just didn't see the point in paying somebody else for something that you could do yourself. If I could do something myself, I'm not going to pay you to do it for me. It's plain and simple. And basically, I sat down and I figured it out. It's like, I could buy my own land, I could buy my own house, and I could set it up to be on wind and solar, and then once it's all paid off, I never have to worry about anything ever again. And I figured out that it would only take me 4 years to pay it all off. So while I was on grid, I was paying $1,100 a month to live on grid and not own anything and not be responsible for anything. I didn't own my house. I didn't own the property. The only thing I owned was my truck and my wife's car. But we didn't have any other than our vehicles. Nothing was really ours. And so we figured it out. It's like $1,100 a month. Where's it all going to? It's going to rent and utilities. Well, we figured out that for $860 a month, we could buy our own land and buy our own cabin. We pay $400 a month for 10 acres of land, which would be paid off, and we got 2 more years and our land's paid off. And $457 a month we pay for our cabin, which will be paid off next year. We got 12 more months and our cabin's paid off. And then after that, in September 2017, everything's paid off and we don't owe anything anymore. And then that's 100% savings after that date. And so we could either continue paying the $1,100 a month for the rest of our lives and not own anything, or we could spend 4 years paying $860 a month and own the land and own the cabin. And then we could pay, we figured out it was going to be about $200 a month for that 4 years to put towards getting stuff for going off grid. So for roughly the same price of $1,100 a month living on grid or $1,100 a month living off grid, we're basically, the cost of going to taking our house off grid over a 4 year period was just more feasible. That's basically why we chose to go off grid. It's like, by the time September 2017 comes around, our land will be paid off, our house will be paid off, and we'll have everything we need to be as close to 100% self-sustaining as possible. We would have been able to purchase enough solar and enough wind to sustain everything, which right now we already have about 2/3 of the solar that we need. And we already have our wind turbines already up, and that provides a great deal of electricity for us. The only thing we need for our wind turbine is slightly larger cable, and we'll be good to go there. But with our solar panels, another 200 watts, and we'll be perfect with our solar panels, and we'll be great. We're way ahead of schedule with everything, and basically for the same price that it cost us to live on grid, we're using that $1,100 a month that it cost us living on grid to live off grid, but we're buying it and we own it, and we're putting it into stuff that we take care of ourselves, and we're not reliant on anybody else. And at the end of 4 years, it's all paid off. And we're already 2 years into it. We've just got 2 more years to go, and we'll own everything. And then at that point in time, that $1,100 a month just goes into our pocket, and we can use it for whatever we want. If we want to buy another cabin, or if we want to go on trips, do whatever we want, buy a new car or something like that, we have it. We could pretty much do whatever we want. So, and to us, land is more valuable than a dollar in a bank. So you can have all the money you want and store it in a bank, and to us, that doesn't mean anything. We don't care if you are a millionaire or a multimillionaire with a crap ton of money in the bank. To us, it doesn't mean anything. 10 acres of land, that means more to me than having $1 million in the bank, because I can do more with this land. This land will ensure that in an off-grid lifestyle, this land right here will ensure my livelihood for my entire life. And if taken care of properly, will ensure my children's lives you know, if I were to have children, it would ensure their lives and then their children's lives and their children's lives. This land can produce our food, it can produce our electricity, it can produce our water, it can produce, it can take care of our waste management needs, it can take care of us as long as we take care of it. And we don't have to rely on anybody else. So, and once you have everything established and set up and running smoothly, then it's a real stress-free environment. Right now, we've got our water, for the most part, our water system's hooked up. Our electric is hooked up and running. We haven't had any power outages since day one. We've had no outages. So there's no stress or anything there. We don't have to do anything to, there's no maintenance or anything with our power system or water system or anything. Our humanure, once every 3 weeks, we empty our compost toilet. And once every 6 months, we rotate our compost bins. You know, it's like, takes 15 minutes once every 3 weeks to change out our compost toilet. And it takes about an hour once every 6 months to rotate our compost bins or compost tumblers and stuff, about an hour once every 6 months. And about, it's a day's work once a year to take them from the bins to the garden and mess that up. You're talking about a minuscule amount of work in our life. Chopping firewood is probably the hardest thing that we have to do off-grid. And my wife and I, we actually enjoy chopping firewood. It's relaxing for us. And chopping firewood is part of land management. If you watched my video where I invited the DCNR County Forester to come out, taking trees down is part of land management and part of caring for your property. So it's relaxing, it's healthy, because it's giving you exercise, swinging an axe and wielding the chainsaw or whatever and walking around your property. It's exercise. And it's enjoyable. So, plus, it's nice to know that your heat for your home is there because you worked hard to get it. And it doesn't take that much effort to do it. So, the other thing that is a daily chore for us off-grid is taking care of our animals. But we enjoy our animals. Not only do we enjoy eating our chickens and eating their eggs, but we also enjoy taking care of them. They're like pets for us. Pets that we can eat. Yeah, what's a better pet than that? Other than our dogs, our guard dogs, and they're good friends. Our chickens are our food and they're friends. And our cats are excellent mousers. So that's basically the three chores that we have living off-grid that we have to do regularly. So it's a real stress-free environment. That's another reason why we chose to go off-grid. So we also like to grow our own food and be aware of where our food comes from. That's part we haven't quite mastered yet, but being off-grid and living where we live, it gives us the ability to have more free time to focus on that and to work on that. And eventually, we hope to be like my neighbor, who has a massive garden and lots of vegetables and stuff. She grows enough vegetables to feed everybody on our street. And we do a lot of egg trade with her. We hope to get to the point where we can actually do that with our own garden, right up here to my right. We've been working on that. We spent the last two summers building up our raised beds and building up the soil and working the soil And so this coming summer, our soil should be just right and just ready for growing a really good garden. So look forward to that next year. And so basically why we went off grid is because we wanted to do things for ourselves. We wanted to grow our own food, be in charge of our own water sources and our own power sources. We wanted to not have to pay somebody else to do things that we could do for ourselves. And we did not go off grid to hide from society. We're not off the social grid, obviously, because I have a YouTube channel and we have internet and phone. We're not off grid to hide from the government or anything like that. We're not off grid to hide from anything. We went off the utility grid, off the power grid, whatever you want to call it. We're off the pay somebody else to take care of us grid. We went off grid to take care of ourselves rather than pay somebody else to do it for us. So thanks for watching, and hopefully that answered your question. And if you have any other questions, feel free to leave them below, and I'll answer them to the best that I can. Thanks for watching.